Hi, I'm Robert Harrison, Training Director here at NLP Institute of California. Now, in this video, I'd like to share with you three qualities of an excellent communicator, according to John Grinder, one of the co-founders of neurolinguistic programming. Now, what John noticed was there's three unique qualities that every excellent communicator really seemed to have and possess and utilize at a high degree of effectiveness. Number one, they know what they want. They're very clear about what they want, and they're clear about how they'll know when they have it, and they have a way to measure it and talk about it that's very, very specific. So that's an important part of knowing what you want, because a lot of us, we think we have an idea of what we want, and when asked, we're very clear about what we don't want, but when it comes to what we actually do want and our criteria for how we'll know when we actually have it, a lot of times we're not that clear. So step one, get very clear, know what you want and be able to speak about it and describe it in specific terms so that you can also measure it. Number two, notice your feedback. John noticed that great communicators, excellent communicators, were really good at noticing their feedback and taking in the information that is being communicated to them. So they're very good at noticing with their eyes, listening with their ears, and sensing with their feelings what was going on at a deeper level. So number two is really be able to notice your feedback and notice if it's working or if it's not working. And number three, John noticed that excellent communicators, well, they had what we call behavioral flexibility, which means if what you're doing isn't working, have the behavioral flexibility, have other options, other skills, other techniques, other processes, other ways of looking at things, perhaps even a different perspective, so that you can have more flexibility in your choice of behaviors so that you're more likely to reach a positive outcome. Many of us, unfortunately, when something isn't working, we keep doing it over and over again, like perhaps our way of communicating with a loved one or with a colleague in a business situation. We try the same approach with everyone, and it only seems to work with some of the people, or it only seems to work some of the time, and then we just stop because we're not sure what to do next. Behavioral flexibility is the answer to that, because it gives us other options, other tools, other techniques to try. And of course, learning NLP is excellent for all three of those domains. So let's recap quickly. Number one, excellent communicators know what they want. Number two, they're noticing their feedback, whether it's working or not. And number three, they have behavioral flexibility. They're willing to do something different if what they're doing isn't working. So I encourage you to apply these three traits of an excellent communicator to your life and see if it doesn't improve your communication right away.